Good morning, this is ACJ News and I'm Gauri, here to update you on the latest news of today. The District Magistrate of Bareilly, Raghavendra Vikram Singh, said in a Facebook post on Sunday that it has become a trend for people to forcefully enter Muslim-dominated localities, raise anti-Pakistan slogans and then create ruckus, the Times of India reported. Singh was referring to the communal clashes in Uttar Pradesh's Kasganj, where one person was killed and property and vehicles were set on fire on Republic Day. The clashes broke out after the residents of the Muslim-dominated locality of Badhunagar in Kasganj arranged chairs on the road and were getting ready to unfurl the tricolour, and workers of Hindu outfits reached the areas and allegedly demanded that the chairs be removed to make way for their bikes. Internet services have been restored in the district after being suspended since yesterday, and a flag march was also conducted today in Kasganj. India thrashed arch-rivals Pakistan by 203 runs in the semi-final of the ICC Under-19 World Cup at the Hagley Oval in Christchurch today. India made it to the final for the sixth time and will now take on Australia in the summit clash on Saturday. At least 36 people, including 10 women, were killed when a West Bengal state roadways bus fell into the Gogra Canal, breaking the railing of the bridge in Murshidabad district on Monday. 25 bodies were identified and search operations is underway to find out more bodies. ₹5 lakh each will be given as compensation to each family of the deceased, and ₹50,000 would be given to other injured people. Even as the political situation in Nepal remains fluid, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj will embark on a visit to the Himalayan nation from 1st to 2nd February. It was announced on Monday. The visit is in keeping with the tradition of regular high-level political exchanges between India and Nepal and reflects expanding bilateral partnership and the importance that two countries attach to further strengthening it across diverse sectors, said External Affairs Minister, said in a statement. The upcoming visit will provide an opportunity to hold discussions with political leaders of Nepal on issues of mutual interest and to advance age-old special ties of friendship between India and Nepal, the statement said. Sushma Swaraj's visit will come in the wake of the parliamentary and local body elections in 2007. A plea seeking contempt action against the government of Rajasthan, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh for not following its order to take stern steps to stop violence in the name of cow vigilantism on Monday led the Supreme Court to seek responses from the three states. The contempt petition has been filed by Tushar Gandhi, the great-grandson of Mahatma Gandhi, and saying that the three states have not complied with the court order which was released on September last year. On 6 September last year, the Apex Court had asked all the states to take stern measures to stop violence in the name of cow protection, including appointing of senior police officers as nodal officer in every district within a week and acting promptly to check cow vigilantes from behaving like they are law unto themselves. FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, a target of frequent and aggressive criticism by President Donald Trump, abruptly stepped down from his position on Monday ahead of his planned retirement this spring. A 22-year veteran of the FBI, McCabe has been publicly and repeatedly lambasted over the past year by Trump, who has accused him of bias because of his wife's political connections and an FBI investigation that produced no criminal charges against Hillary Clinton. Around 47 million children in India under 5 years of age reside in areas where particulate matter levels exceed the prescribed limits, with 17 million among them inhabiting places where the pollution levels are twice the limits, says a recent report. Airpocalypse 2, a Greenpeace India report, said children are worst affected in states such as Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Bihar, Maharashtra and Delhi respectively. It said Delhi remained the worst impacted city, with annual PM levels exceeding approximately 5 times the national ambient of for quality standards. According to the report, a massive part of the population, that is 580 million or 47%, are living in areas where no air quality data is available. That's all for today. Thank you.